Hey guys, it's General Heat here. How's everyone doing today? So, for today's video, well, by now you're probably aware that Halo the Master Chief Collection on Xbox finally got a really huge update. This is about 1 week after Halo CE came out for MCC on PC. But this Xbox update is huge. It's like a whopping 60 gigabytes, and it touches like pretty much all the games. It's mostly CE focused, but there's a lot of other games involved. So for this video, we'll be taking a look at what's new, what's fixed, and unfortunately what's broken. Now, not everything that's broken or works worse is necessarily a bug. Some things are like, you know, just PSAs or visual things that are changed. But let's get right into it. So we're starting with what's broken, and with that, we're going to be tackling Halo 1 cutscene skipping on co-op. So a new feature introduced with Halo 1 on MCC PC and now Xbox is that they made cutscene skipping consistent with Halo Reach, which means you're supposed to press A and then press Y to skip the cutscene, whereas in the past, you just simply press A to skip the cutscene. Well, when you play on co-op on Halo 1, when you press A, it doesn't bring up anything to press Y, no prompt to press Y to skip the cutscene. So if you're playing co-op and you find that you can't skip the cutscene anymore, that's because you have to press Y. The prompt is missing. And it's actually the same with Halo 3, except with Halo 3, it happens on both solo and co-op. You can mash A all you want, and that's, you know, how you're originally supposed to skip cutscenes on Halo 3. But, you know, there's no prompt that pops up that say you also have to press Y, like on Halo Reach. So, again, if you find you can't skip cutscenes on Halo 3, try pressing the Y button after pressing the A button. Now, for this next bug, or what's broken next, is on ODST. This is a really old bug, actually, that goes like way back to one of the early versions of MCC after they started fixing it. And it only happens if you have a 4K HDR Xbox One X. As you can see, the lighting is like really broken with HDR on, and your screen will be flashing a lot on a lot of instances. And when you have visor on, you get shot by plasma weapons. Well, as you can see, it is flashing like crazy. And the more you get shot, especially when it rapid fires, your screen just like, it flashes a lot. And on like a big TV with like HDR enabled, it's even worse. And it's like, it's not good for your eyes really. So I guess it's a warning there, or heads up. Now this next one, for those of you who played it already, you've probably noticed this issue. And a lot of people have been posting on it on Twitter, Reddit, the forums and stuff. There's a lot of frame rate issues. Even on an Xbox One X, an anniversary graphics, compared to classic, the frame rate's like almost half in some cases. It might be hard to tell in this video, but especially if you have an Xbox One X, and I've heard like OG Xbox One and Xbox One S has the issues as well, you can see like when you look around, the frame rate is really choppy, but then when you switch to classic, it's fine. Unfortunately, it's not just CE Anniversary that has the issue. It's also Halo 2. Actually, it's really bad in Halo 2 Anniversary graphics sometimes, especially on the really open maps, and this applies for CE as well. But on really open maps, such as this one here, again, it might be hard to tell in this video, because the game DVR does not necessarily capture it properly, but you could see that the frame rate is really low, especially when I was shooting there. You could see like the muzzle flash was like kind of choppy, whereas in classic it's perfectly fine. And you know, it only happens in anniversary graphics where the frame rate tanks, and it wasn't always like that. And unfortunately, it also carries over to Halo 3 as well. It's not as bad in Halo 3, in campaign at least, but it is definitely noticeable. And for example, one of the best examples actually is at the beginning of the Covenant when you get off. Especially when there's like a lot of smoke and dust and stuff, the frame rate, it gets really slow here and there. And then as you play through this beginning part of the mission, there are other times and other spots during this mission where your frame rate will be lower than 60 FPS, even on an Xbox One X. Now, I've had quite a few people help me test this and confirm it on their end. It seems like it's actually worse on the Xbox One X when you're playing in 4K. If you're not in 4K, if you're playing on a 1080p TV, then it's not as bad. However, one very consistent frame rate stutter is in multiplayer and Forge and custom games. you might not be able to see in the video because of game DVR, but every now and then, like very consistently, like every few minutes, the game would just stutter for a second. And, you know, it's, I don't know like why that happens. But hopefully that's fixed soon. Next, for Halo CE, normally during cutscenes, and you can see the anniversary graphic still, it letterboxes, which means those black bars on top and bottom show up, and you have a little caption in the bottom right. So in anniversary graphics, it works correctly. But in classic graphics, those letterboxes are gone. They are missing. And I'm inclined to believe that it's a bug, because, you know, in anniversary graphics, it's still letterboxes. So it's probably missing from classic graphics for some reason. But it actually looks kind of cool without the letterboxes. So, you know, in the future, it'd actually be a cool feature if you have a toggle to enable or disable letterboxing on demand. Now, for this next one, the CE HUD safe area has been changed on MCC. It is now, according to the patch notes, it was meant to be made more consistent with OG, but it's actually more consistent with the Gearbox port of Halo PC, whereas on the original MCC CEA, as well as CEA on the 360 version and OG Xbox version, the HUD is supposed to be like kind of more inside the screen. The safe area is supposed to be lower. And that's consistent through all versions of CE except for the Gearbox PC port. And now the MCC version has been brought to consistency with the Gearbox port, which, you know, it's not really OG. But that is something that I wanted to point out. Alright, so that's basically all that I know off the top of my head that's broken or works worse with the new Xbox update. Now we're going to be taking a look at what's new and what's been fixed. There's actually a lot of interesting new stuff that I actually don't know what the purpose is. So we're going to start with Halo 3. The teleporters have been changed on Halo 3. In Forge, when you spawn a teleporter, it now has this thing like circling around it. Like this is the thing that you would see like with King of the Hill. But it now circles around the center of the teleporter, whether it's on or off. And I don't know why it's there. My friend thinks it's... I have a couple friends with different theories. One thinks it's supposed to be made consistent with Halo Reach, because I think the Halo Reach stuff has a lot of this stuff surrounding it. Another friend, actually Fox Smash, who's the one that pointed this out to me, he thinks that it might be, you know, in preparation for adding features on Halo Reach teleporters. Because in Halo Reach teleporters, you can teleport vehicles, you can now teleport projectiles, actually. So that might be something they're adding to the Halo 3 teleporter, and this is just something in preparation. Or, you know, it could just be totally aesthetic and doesn't serve an actual functional purpose. But it is something new they added to Halo 3 Forge, which currently we don't really know what it does yet, and it's not in the official patch notes either. Speaking of other stuff that's not in the official patch notes, the Halo 4 water ripples. If you guys remember, like, several videos way back, and there's been multiple documented cases of this, the Halo 4 water was originally broken. As in, when you drove through the water or walked through it, it does not ripple. It's almost like you're phasing through the water. Well, now that's been fixed, finally. The water in Halo 4 is now totally functional. When you drive vehicles through it, not only does it splash like it always did, but now it actually ripples correctly. And the ripples look pretty nice. It was before it was actually pretty immersion-breaking when the water didn't ripple and drove through it. It just looked really weird when there's no ripples. But now that there are ripples, it looks great and looks proper. And of course, multiplayer has been fixed as well. But I do want to point out that at least on the map Ragnarok in Halo 4, the water ripples may not be as apparent. So if you think that the water is still broken in multiplayer, it's not. The best way to tell is, like, you know, look straight down and walk backwards or shoot at it, you can still see it ripple. And of course in Halo 2 Anniversary, which is based on Halo 4, the water ripples have not been fixed. And you can see there that it still doesn't ripple when you drive through it. Alright, so the next thing that's been fixed is the turrets on the Spirit dropships in Halo 1. So, not too long ago on Halo MCC, for CE specifically of course, when the Spirit dropships fired their Phantom turrets or their Shade turret shots, they don't fire from the turret, they fire from the center of the ship where I'm shooting at. Well, now it's been fixed and they correctly fire from the center, from the turrets now. So, it's a small but good fix there. This next one is a bug that was actually, you know, I brought up like years ago, and it's actually another bug that Fox Smash showed to me. So it has to do with the shield doors, both the small and large one, specifically on Rat's Nest. On other maps, I believe the shield doors are fine, But specifically on this map, the physics were quite broken for the shield doors, and each one had a different problem with the physics. But I can now confirm that those have all been fixed. I actually don't know for a fact if it was fixed in this particular update. Maybe it was fixed earlier, I just didn't notice. But now I have noticed, and it is fixed, so I do want to bring it up, whether it was fixed in this build or not. But, you know, previously, the physics were wrong, where that if you put the shield doors on a box, and then you delete the box, one of them would drop down to the ground, and then the other shield door you could actually push around, and, you know, kind of, it just wouldn't block anything. But that's all been fixed now. Now, another thing that's been improved, and I did bring this up on my video yesterday about new things on Halo MCC PC, is that now you won't accidentally skip cutscenes anymore. You can now, when you try to skip cutscenes by pressing A, it now brings up a second prompt that says press Y to skip. And that's with not every cutscene in Halo CE is skippable, but the ones that can be skipped, you will have that prompt. Of course, as you saw earlier in the video at the beginning, if you play on co-op and you try to skip, then the prompt won't come up. It only comes up when you play on solo. But as you can see here, with the same cutscene that I showed in that first example for that bug, I do have the prompt to skip when I'm playing on solo. So this next thing, just like on a PC version, Halo CE terminals have now been greatly improved. Now, from my video on Halo PC for MCC, some people did mention terminals still have a few issues, and indeed some of them don't always work after a while, and you did like restart your game or something, or some audio bugs persist and stuff like that, but it's a step in the right direction. And what I mean by that, for those of you who didn't watch my video yesterday, is that now when you use the terminals, you no longer have to launch the Halo app, which was really annoying to do back in the day. The terminals now play in-game when you start them up, at least they're supposed to. But, you know, some people say there's been some bugs with that. But for the most part, you don't need the Halo Channel app anymore. So that's really great. Now, the next thing that's new, and one of the really big headline features of Halo CE, is now the classic sound effects have been brought back to Halo 1. And by classic sound effects, I mean like, you know, the original sound effects on the original Xbox version of CE. Not the new anniversary sound effects that have been pretty much exclusively used on MCC. And in addition to the sound effects, the music is back as well. So that also applies to multiplayer, and you can toggle between whichever one you want. And you know, it's quite nostalgic to experience the classic sound effects again. I've actually made it my default in most cases, but every now and then I'll still use the anniversary sound effects. So the next thing that's been brought to Xbox is the customization for the PC version. Not surprisingly, of course, but just like with Halo Reach, how it was eventually brought to the Xbox version, now you can do a CE as well. But as you saw in my PC video, if you saw that video, the customization, it's not as, you know, comprehensive or in-depth as the Halo Reach one, because, you know, you don't have armor variants on Halo CE. But you can still preview the changes to your armor color live on an actual 3D Spartan model, so that's pretty cool. And I'm glad they brought it to Xbox finally. And last but not least, to come full circle, the big noticeable change, improvement, or new thing is the new background video. It is much higher quality than all the other previous ones, and it looks really cool as well. And of course, it's Halo CE themed to coincide with Halo CE coming to MCC PC. So that's a really cool thing they added there. But yeah, so there you guys have it. That's basically what's in the big new Xbox update for Halo MCC, and as well as what's new, fixed, and what's broken now on the new update. But hopefully you guys did find this video to be informative, and hopefully it helps you guys if you get confused with some of the bugs that show up. But if it did help you, and if you did enjoy the video, make sure to leave a like, leave your thoughts in the comments, anything you think I missed, or anything you want to add, just let me know in the comments. But other than that, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe, and I will see you all next time. Bye, guys.